morning, boys and girls, and welcome to the CM Worship for Easter Sunday. This is March the 31st, 2024. Happy Easter, everyone. So today, because it is Easter, I want us to do a cheer together, okay? So Pastor Amy's going to say, Christ is risen. And then I want you to say, He is risen indeed. Okay? Are you ready? Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Good job, kids. Let's stand up to worship our Lord together. Okay, let's pray together, kids. Thank you, Jesus, that you sacrificed your own body to pay the penalty on the cross for our sins. We thank you, Lord, that you did not stay dead, but you came back to life on the third day, just like you said you would. Give us the joy to celebrate Easter together as a church family. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Well, kids, let's do a quick recap in terms of what we learned on Good Friday. So we know that Jesus was sentenced to death by Pontius Pilate. He died a criminal's death on the cross beside two criminals, right? There was one on his left and one on his right. After he was pronounced dead, Jesus' body was taken off the cross and it was placed in a tomb that was actually owned by Joseph of Arimathea. He wrapped up the body in linen cloths and then put it into the tomb, and a big stone was rolled in front of it so that no one could steal the body. The angel of the Lord revealed to the woman that Jesus is not there anymore, but he had risen. And the woman, after hearing this message from the angel, ran back to find the disciples to tell them what they had seen and heard. And Peter and John also went to the tomb to check to see what the woman had seen. And they also saw that Jesus' body was not there. Only the linen cloths were there that had been used to wrap Jesus' body. So Jesus knew that he would one day appear to his disciples and to the women. And they would be shocked or afraid when he came to see them. So why don't we watch our Bible video today to find out more about what happens when Jesus appears to his disciples. We're going to look for three clues to help us to indicate how would the disciples know that Jesus is alive. Okay, let's watch Bible video now.
On the first day of the week, in the evening, Jesus' disciples gathered together in a house in Jerusalem. News about Jesus was spreading. Some of Jesus' followers reported that Jesus wasn't dead anymore. Two of Jesus' followers told the other disciples that Jesus had appeared to them on the road to Emmaus. They had traveled with him, and once they reached their destination, they invited him to stay with them. They had recognized him when he broke bread with them. As the disciples talked, Jesus came and stood among them. "Peace to you," he said. The disciples were surprised and terrified. They couldn't believe their eyes. Was this really Jesus? The disciples thought they were seeing a ghost. "Why are you afraid?" Jesus asked. "It's me. Why do you doubt? Look at me and touch me. You can see that I am not a ghost. A ghost does not have flesh and bones like I do." Jesus showed the disciples his hands and his side. They saw the holes in Jesus' hands and in his side. It seemed too good to be true, but Jesus really was alive. "Do you have anything here to eat?" Jesus asked. The disciples gave Jesus some fish, and he ate it. Jesus talked to the disciples and explained the Bible to them. He helped them understand how the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms told about him. The scriptures said the Messiah would suffer and rise from the dead so that people could be forgiven their sins. Then Jesus told the disciples that they had a job to do. The disciples needed to tell other people to repent from their sin and be forgiven. For 40 days, Jesus presented himself to over 500 people and proved that he is alive. 1 Corinthians 15:3 through 8. Jesus is still alive today. He sends out believers to tell others about him.
All right, welcome back. So did anybody pick up on some clues that would indicate to the disciples that Jesus is really alive? What would be the proof to show that Jesus was actually living and he wasn't dead? Clue number one is this. Jesus had a physical body. When he appeared in front of the disciples, he showed the disciples his nail-scarred hands and feet, and he invited the disciples to touch it. So Jesus came back in a physical body. He resurrected in a physical form so that everybody could see him. So that's clue number one. Jesus came back in a physical, resurrected body. And clue number two is that Jesus asked for something to eat. Now, does anybody know why is that important that Jesus asked the disciples for something to eat? Now, let's think about this. Can people who are dead or not alive anymore, are they hungry? No, they're not hungry anymore because they're gone. They're dead, right? But only people who are living and alive are hungry, okay? So that's an indication that Jesus is actually alive. Another clue that Jesus is alive and he's not dead. Okay, clue number three is this. When Jesus appears to the 11 disciples, he has a conversation with them. Now, why is this a clue? Let's think about this. So if you were dead, and you are not alive anymore, can you have a conversation with somebody? No. Okay, so if you know somebody who passed away, or somebody who's not here anymore, a grandma, grandpa, maybe a relative of some sort, can they talk to you? No, they cannot talk to you. You may be able to talk to them, but they cannot talk to you back, right? They have no more air in their lungs, their brains are not working anymore, so it's impossible for them to have a conversation with you. So then, how is it possible then that Jesus had a conversation with his disciples? Because he was living, and he was alive, and he was in human form. And that's why he is able to converse with his disciples. So that is clue number three. Jesus had a conversation with his disciples. So let's review again. What are the things that show or indicate or prove that Jesus is alive? One, he appeared to his disciples in bodily form. Two, Jesus asked his disciples for food. He was hungry. Three, Jesus was having a conversation and talking to his disciples. So these are three amazing clues and proof that show that Jesus is alive. And he came back to life just as he said he would. And another thing that's really interesting to remember is that Jesus did not just appear to his 11 disciples, but he also appeared to 500 people for the 40 days that he was on earth. 500 people witnessed Jesus in his resurrected body, okay? And they all agreed that Jesus is alive. So that is a miracle, right? And spiritually, Jesus' resurrection means a lot to us too. Because Jesus died and rose again, we have eternal hope in him. He broke the penalty of our sin so that when we place our trust and faith in Jesus, our sins can be forgiven and we can be made right with God again. Or what Pastor Stephen said in his video, we can be reconciled with God. And that is good news, right? Yes, it's always good news to have a relationship with Jesus. So let's pray together. Thank you, Jesus, that you are a living hope. Because you died on the cross for our sins and you came back to life, we have new life and hope in you. Help us to share the good news with others who still do not know you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Let's respond by singing a song. Thank you. Okay, let's stand up to receive our benediction for today. May the grace of our Lord Jesus, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all until we see him again. Amen. Have yourself a wonderful week and happy Easter.
God chooses on